So for whatever reason, Anchor doesn't sponsor my show anymore. I don't know if they're doing that for everybody that uploads their podcast through Anchor or if they just targeted me specifically. Either way, the show is truly, legitimately free now. Like, I would be getting paid. Actually, I am currently being paid actually nothing to do the show.
With your broke ass.
Just kidding. I'm going to keep doing it forever, and ideally one day I will get paid to just do this. But in the meantime, I'm going to give Cash App literally some free promo just to see if it, you know, supports the show. If you don't currently use Cash App, I'm going to leave a link in the description. Cash App is basically an app that makes it super easy to send and receive money with like very, very, very minimal fees. Like, actually, the fees could be essentially non-existent if you choose to just like have that money be transferred within a couple of days. But if you choose to do it instantly, sometimes there's like a 25 cent fee or something. It's just super simple. Like, I'm sure you've been out somewhere with somebody and you don't feel like splitting the bill or doing two separate orders, and somebody just says, oh, I'll Cash App you. If you're the type of person that every time they say that, you're like, I don't have Cash App. Well, now here's your time. Tap on my link in the description and get yourself set up with Cash App, and it'll give you $5 free, and it'll also give me $5 free. That'll probably just go towards, like, I don't know, like rent or my podcast or whatever. So if you want to support the show, you can do it that way. And let's just get into it.
Therapy Season 3 of Therapy
Season 3 of
So, I've clearly mastered relationships because I'm married. So, we're moving on to something else. I actually found a subreddit called r/friendship where people are looking for advice on how to deal with their friends and situations that involve them. Now, I happen to have some incredible friends myself. A lot of them have been featured on this show. And I've been able to maintain like the same core group of friends for some around a half decade, some closer to a whole decade. And I feel like I have like a pretty nuanced experience take on a lot of the conflicts and situations, issues that friends may come across when dealing with one another, especially as we all get older and grow into fully developed, fully functioning adults. So I'm going to go through a couple of posts today and I'm going to give some unsolicited advice. Here we go.
Throughout my life, I've always felt like the friend who has made the most effort. Acquaintances have said I let people walk all over me. And maybe I do. Recently, I've just got so fed up with friendships that require me to make the most effort. I've seemed to be the one who reaches out, who lends an ear or shoulder to cry on, yet no one does that for me. I constantly feel like the convenience friend. Everyone else has friends or partners they're closer to, and I'm the friend they contact when everyone else is busy. Sometimes I feel it's because of the way I look. I mean, I'm quite overweight, caused by an eating disorder. All of my friends are petite and attractive. They always say I'm funny and dependable, but they'd always choose their other skinnier, prettier friends to go out with and post on social media. I feel like I'm starting to question whether any of my friends actually really like me, or whether I'm just convenient for them, because I equally feel as easy to drop.
I think that there's a movie about this. It's called Duff, and I think it's an acronym for the designated ugly fat friend, which is awful, by the way. Like, it's supposed to be a comedy, but like when you really think about it, it's really sad. So let's break this down like one bit at a time.
Break it down.
So initially they're talking about being the friend that makes the most effort, and people saying that they allow people to walk all over them. I think that that's two different things. I mean, allowing people to walk all over you, that shouldn't even be just exclusive to friendship. You just shouldn't be down for that in general. But it's a lot easier for other people to see that from the outside looking in. So that's definitely something I would examine, not just from a friendship perspective.
There you go.
But if you're at work or you're dealing with your family or anything like that, you should always stick up for yourself, of course. But as far as making the most effort, I definitely had friendships like that before where it seemed like I was always the one reaching out first. And I do agree that can be exhausting, but you just have to ask yourself, is that the type of friendship that I want? Can I live with that? Or is it making me feel bad about myself? And over time, I had a situation like that with an old friend, and I started to feel really down about it. Like, they thought they were better than me or too good for me, or I was just convenient for them. And I think I talked about that in a previous episode where sometimes you have friends that are just around for like a certain season of your life, like friends you were only with because you were in college together, or you were roommates, or you saw each other when you were playing intramural soccer. So I think it's really important to determine what kind of people are meant to be your friends for a long period of time, regardless of where you live or where you're at in your life, or if they're just meant for, you know, a certain season, you know? Also, I can absolutely tell that this person posting just so happens to be a girl or a woman. I don't know how old she is, because they're referencing things like their friends being petite and attractive. I've never described any of my male friends like that. But I do think that is something that could be common amongst women. I would have to ask one of my female friends, like Katie or my wife or something like that. But as far as like wanting to hang out with people that are like better looking, that's definitely something that could be a thing that's at play there. Men do not think like that at all. Like, if I thought any of my guy friends were ugly, like, that doesn't mean anything to me. Like, you're either cool to hang out with or not. So that's another factor that women unfortunately have to deal with. And that's unfortunate, because friendship has nothing to do with how hot you are. I don't think it should. So yeah, I would just re-examine all those friendships and see if, you know, if you're willing to be that kind of friend, then that's okay. If you don't mind reaching out first, that's fine. But it sounds like you don't, and it sounds like it's kind of targeted. So drop them. Find people that actually appreciate you, you know, regardless of what they look like. So here's another person that is looking for advice. They said,
basically, my friend keeps calling me gay, homophobic, dumb, skinny, weak, slow, etc. And I'm honestly just fed up with it. I take insults like that seriously, and we've been friends for a good 4.5-ish years. I know some of you will try to say that I should just end the friendship right there, but the truth is, my friend has been good for most of the time we've been friends. What should I do?
End the friendship. Look, I can tolerate a certain amount of like sideways comments and disrespect here and there, but it's really, really important to establish boundaries. And I think that's one of the first comments under this post says, but I can speak from personal experience. I hate name calling if it's something that's like actually harmful. Like somebody calling you dumb or skinny or weak or slow, that's not like, that sounds like a personal attack. That doesn't sound like you're just roasting your friends or whatever. Like, it's one thing to, like, I was hanging out with a couple of friends a couple of days ago, and they were wearing, like, one of them was wearing, like, a black shirt and, like, a necklace, and one of my friends told another one of my friends that you look like The Rock right now.
Shut up, bitch! Oh, my God!
Which is really funny, but it's one thing to be like, oh, you look like this person, ha ha ha, and they're like, oh, I agree, to be like, you look like an idiot, honestly, like, you look like you don't know how to dress yourself, like, that's not in jest. I don't really see how you can like jokingly say that somebody is dumb and skinny and weak. Like, that sounds like they're bullying you. That doesn't sound like your friend. So even though they say that they don't want advice that just says they should end the friendship, why not? They don't even sound like a friend to you. I talk to people for my new job now. I talk to people all day that are not my friends and owe me absolutely nothing. And none of them say anything like that to me. So, like, I had a friend in college, and one day, I forgot exactly what led up to it, but he just got, like, really angry and was just calling me names.
Shut your bitch ass up!
Shut the fuck up, you nasty bitch!
Nobody gives a shit!
Can you shut the fuck up?
Boy, if you don't... Shut your...
And I was, like, really upset about it, but I didn't actually, like, confront him and be like, hey, it is unacceptable to speak to me that way. Like, I just stopped talking to him for a little bit until he realized, like, oh, maybe it had something to do with me lashing out at Derek for, like, really no good reason. And then he kind of apologized. Well, he, like, halfway apologized. He was like, hey, I think I got really drunk the other night, and I might have said some things that I didn't really mean. And I was like, you know what? Good enough. As long as, like, you acknowledge that that happened, it's fine. But there's no reason to say in any type of partnership, relationship, friendship, where somebody is calling you names that make you feel bad about yourself. Like, you don't need those people in your life. So, you know, there's that.
So I have a few friends from my locality.
Interesting word choice there.
Where I grew up in. We're in our 20s now, and I've somewhat drifted apart from them due to no fault of my own. They're more comfortable with each other and find it easy to exclude me whenever they are hanging out. While I've communicated a few times that this bothers me, it still continues and it hurts me whenever it happens. They still leave me out and it leads to a great sense of loneliness. I do have more friends who are active and perhaps actually want me there, but being left out by this particular group makes me wonder if something is wrong with me or I'm not worthy of it. Need advice on how to expect less or stop being disappointed.
It sounds like you already kind of found the answer. I think you should just expect less from them. The idea of like begging people to include me and stuff sounds like so... icky. Like, I would hate to be in that position. And it sounds like you have another group of people that actually like you and want to have you around. I think it's natural as you grow older to realize, oh, these certain friends are good for these type of hangs out.
Try again.
Certain friends are good for this type of hangout, and certain friends are good for this kind of hangout. And some of your best friends are good for every type of hangout. But if you are like naturally drifting away from this pair or this group of people, it's just natural. And I'm sure that they are, it's not an accident. Like, they are consciously choosing not to hang out with you. And like,
it's okay.
Honestly, it's cool. A lot of times when I'm hanging out with one or two people and we're wondering whether or not we should invite a third or fourth person, we wonder to ourselves, we don't say things like they wouldn't be fun here or we don't like them. It's simply, we aren't going to be participating in the type of thing that we think they would be like a good fit for. So like, for example, if you are going out drinking with your friends and you have a friend that doesn't drink, maybe that's not their kind of hangout, you know? I mean, and you might have made that choice for them. I mean, some would argue, oh, it's courteous to ask them if they want to go out. But like, if they're like a recovering alcoholic or they just don't drink like that, why would you invite them out to go drink? My friend Jordan has this friend named Josh, and they both enjoy going to Buffalo Wild Wings to watch fights. Now, even though I love Jordan and I love hanging out with him, if I found out that even though I was in Chattanooga and he decided to go watch a UFC fight with Josh and not me, I wouldn't resent Jordan for that because I like the UFC, but not that much. Like, it wouldn't be that big of a deal. So sometimes you can overthink these things, and sometimes people are actively trying to exclude you. But regardless, you should not be begging these people to hang out with you. Also, you've already communicated to them that like your feelings are hurt, and if they're still continuing to do it, like they clearly don't think you're like a good fit to hang out with them the times where they're excluding you. So let it go and expect less, or just focus on the people that like you more. And it's pretty simple stuff.
I need some advice, okay? So me and my friend were having a conversation, and I told her how my sister was in Germany for a while, and she said, oh, where the Nazis are. I thought that was a bit insensitive, or am I just being overdramatic?
You're just being overdramatic.
I realized I have a crush on my friend when she started going out with a girl almost 3 weeks ago. I will confess to her about my crush and then distance myself from the friendship for a while.
You what?
What should I keep in mind? Any tips on what to say or what not to say?
What?
Okay. So you have a crush on your friend because she started dating this other girl, and now you think it's a good time to confess your crush and then just like leave her alone. Just don't do it. That's what should you keep in mind? Any tips on what not to say? Don't say it. Just don't. If you have a crush on the girl and like you're ready to like unload that and let them know how you feel, don't do that while they're in a relationship with somebody. Like, why would you do that?
Hey, no, stop. Just calm down. Don't do it.
That's gonna kind of make things awkward. Giving them space isn't actually going to help either, to just be like,
oh my God, congratulations, you found somebody that you connect with on a level that's like so great that you want to be exclusive with them. Congratulations. Also,
I like you too.
Like, why would you do that? Don't do that. It's a bad idea. Don't. I'm down with shooting your shot. Like, that's awesome. It's great that you've come to terms with the fact that like you have feelings for this person. But you missed your window. Now, the window can open again, but after that relationship ends, unless you think this person is going to marry the other person. This is the beautiful thing about modern relationships, especially like American ones. They come, they go, they start, they end. Unless they're going to marry this person, you're going to have another shot with them. So just wait until they break up. And in the meantime, you know, just stay lurking. Just be a good friend and just hang. But like, you don't, no, the timing's off. Don't do it. Just don't. The advice is stop.
Stop it. Get some help.
Hey, I hope you all enjoyed this session of Derapy. I should have a little Derapy news out tomorrow. And I say that truthfully because I'm literally going to record it right after I finish this one. So I love you. I mean it. Thank you so much for continuing to listen to my little show. I'm putting so much work into it and I'm never going to stop doing it. Check out my YouTube, subscribe. It's literally free. Everything I'm doing is free. If you want to be a good friend tap my link in the description and get yourself Cash App. If you don't already have it, get yourself $5 free bucks. Get me $5 free bucks. I have no official partnership with Cash App, by the way, so nobody try to sue me. But this is just a way I can help the people that listen to this show out while also help me out, because for the foreseeable future, I'm going to be doing the show for free, solely for your entertainment and also mine. So love you. Mean it. Enjoy the outro. See you soon. Yeah.